Hello again, this is Kent, and we are in Inkscape Tutorials for Beginners series. Video number 5, Creating and Managing Documents. And first, we will talk about starting a new file. If you're already in Inkscape, well, if you're not in Inkscape and you open up Inkscape, well, you'll be in a new file. And it'll usually, I guess it'll be the default file. But you can always make changes to, let's say, you're in a portrait mode and you want to go into landscape. Well, that can be done, and I'll show you eventually how to do that. Also, if you're already in Inkscape and you want to create a new instance of Inkscape, you can go to New and under File menu and then click Default, or sometimes I will go with Landscape. Now, if you have interest in creating some of these other items that you see, business card, CD, then you'll want to select one of these others. And you'll have to play around with the one that would be best for you. Oftentimes I will go with landscape, but if I don't, then I'll just change it within document properties. Also, you can go in, open up a previous file, either by already being in Inkscape and you go to open, or you can go to open recent, or if you're in, or maybe you're in one of your folders and you just go to the location where your file is that you want to open it, and you just double click it. Usually when you install Inkscape, it will, whatever SVG file you double click on, it will open into Inkscape. And so the next thing I wanted to do was, okay, let's say that we did go into a new file, default, and I wanted to change this. I changed some document properties in here. Especially, right now it's in portrait mode. I want to go in and change it to landscape. Go to document, file, and then document properties. Just go to landscape. Now it has all these other settings that you can change it to. See, there's similar to when you're opening up a new file. Well, they're almost probably exactly the same. But you can make those page size settings or changes if you want. And you have pixels, millimeters. Oftentimes people use either pixels or millimeters. You have the width and height. And there's other settings. Show page border, and that's how I have by default. This is the page border. I also want to point out that there's definitely some other items that you can change for your document properties. As you see up here in the tabs, you'll just have to, right, I don't have time to go all in all this stuff. It'll make the video a lot longer. But they're somewhat self-explanatory, so let's just move on. Now, let's say that we were in a file, and we wanted to open up another file into this. Maybe there's a drawing in Inkscape that we wanted to import or copy and paste or something like that. Well, to get that in there, there's various ways you can do it. Probably the easiest way to do it would be, let's say we have this folder, we want to get this penguin in here. All you have to do is simply click on it and drag it in. You do the same thing with a photo, a bitmap drawing or something, you know, that whether it's a JPEG or a GIF, GIF, or a PNG file. Those kind of files, those kind of bitmap files, even I would assume a BMP file, which is a bitmap file. That's the easiest way, is to just drag it in. But you can also I deleted the file that I didn't want, but I can get it back. I'll just delete this. And the other way you can do it is you can go to import. Just click import, and then find your file that you want and open it up that way. And it can be, you can also open up a bitmap, a JPEG, PNG, or GIF, whatever, and do it that way. The only and there's another way is if you had another, let's say that you have another instance of Inkscape, you can actually copy it and paste. The only time you can't do that is if it's not in the same process, meaning if I already have, I can just copy this and then come over here and paste it. The only time you cannot do that is if you open Inkscape from your programs and you have two separate processes of Inkscape. You try to copy the item in the other process or instance of Inkscape in a different process, and you won't be able to paste it in your first process of Inkscape. And it kind of gets confusing, but if you find that you can't paste something, you'll remember what I'm talking about. I think that's about it. The other thing is that you can open up, you have various windows of Inkscape, and you can change, between the Inkscapes, or the instances of Inkscape, by clicking Alt-Tab. Notice that? I mean, it's just similar to other Windows software. I think that's it. Well, if you like this video or you like this series, please like this video and please subscribe. Thank you very much.